أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله. She could be one of the millions and millions and billions of human beings who were born to this life, who lived their life, then they pass away like they never existed. However, this is not true for Umm Ammar. Her destiny was different. She received the glad tidings to be in heaven, and she had several certificates of achievement. The highest of them, the martyrdom. She was the first martyred person in Islam, and she was a woman. Her name is Sumayya bint al-Khayyat. Some references make it Khabbat. And she was a maid, a servant at the household of Abu Hudhayf ibn al-Mughira al-Makhzumi. She met a new arrival guy from Yemen who became Halif or a worker with Abu Hudhayfa. His name is Yasir ibn Malik al-Ansi. Very soon they fell in love and their master agreed for them to marry, and they were the happiest couple. And that marriage gave a fruit, a boy with the name Ammar. Ammar needs volumes and volumes to write about him, but let's focus on Sumayya and her husband Yasir. Very early on, the news spread, especially among the weak, the servants, the slaves, the underprivileged, the widowed, the orphans, of the message of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, of mercy, love, and compassion. وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ. The young man, Ammar, did not waste any time, and he went to the place where the early Muslims were meeting, at the house of Al-Arqam ibn Abi Al-Arqam. And there at the door, he met Bilal ibn Rabah Al-Habashi, and he met Suhayb ibn Sinan al-Rumi, and the three of them accepted Islam and they gave the pledge and alliance to the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the Muslim then were probably handful, 7 or 8 only. And Ammar went back home and told his parents of his decision and what he did. And both of them were very excited to meet the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and they did. And they accepted Islam. And the news of such a thing cannot be hidden, and started spreading from one person to one person till it reached the Bani Makhzum, Abu Hudhayfa, and the rest of the clan. And here, a lot of pressure been applied for them to abandon their belief and the new religion they adopted. Psychological and emotional pressure was applied. Then comes the physical abuse and the torture. And the three of them received a torture which you cannot read in the books. It's similar to the torture we hear about done by the despotic countries in the third world countries. And they refuse to abandon their religion. Abu Jahl used to be known Mr. Wise, Abu al-Hakam, Amr ibn Hisham al-Makhzumi, and he is the nephew of Abu Hudhayfa ibn al-Mughira al-Makhzumi. He headed the torture team, and he used every abuse in the books to make them under pressure and duress and pain to abandon this religion. But they refused. And amazingly, the strongest of the three was Sumayya, who faced Abu Jahl, and an exchange happened, and Abu Jahl was irate. And he took his spear and he stabbed her in her lower abdomen, and that spear came out of her back. And she died instantly on the pole where she was tied up to with her husband and her son. And she was the first martyr in Islam. During all these weeks and months of torture, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam would pass by, and he's helpless, doesn't have the clout or the numbers or the commandments of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to take any physical action, because that's tied with the government, with the land, and with constitution. And this didn't happen till the second stage in Medina, where he behaved as a statesman, as a leader, as a governor. So the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he would pass by and encourage them, and his words were as a balsam, as a soothing ointment on their wounds. And he would tell them, صَبْرًا آلَ يَاسِرْ فَإِنَّ مَوْعِدَكُمُ الْجَنَّةِ. Patience, the family of Yasir, we will meet in heaven, in paradise. Yasir, not too long after, also he was martyred. And Ammar continued to suffer till eventually the hijrah happened and the abuse and suffering was alleviated. May Allah have His mercy and blessing on the family of Yasir, on Sumayya bint al-Khayyat, Ummu Ammar, the first martyred woman in Islam, and the first martyred person in Islam, who will stop here and inshallah continue with another person who reached the lofty goal, being in heaven and be immortalized in our conscience and mind and hearts. 1400 years after the incidents, they are alive and vivid when we come to their memory. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.